This is Allison's Bootleg cart, or ABC. It's new, and it's cool. It's an open source flash cart that uses flash memory to store ROMs, and battery-backed SRAM to store game saves. You need to use a cartridge flasher, like the GBX cart, to copy ROMs and save files. So in that sense, it's pretty similar to something like an Inside Gadgets flash cart. But the ABC has an extra trick up its sleeve. When I made a flash card on this channel, it was only usable for ROMs that are 32K or less. That's because I hooked the memory chip directly up to the cartridge connectors, and the Game Boy can only directly access 32 kilobytes of data from a cartridge's ROM. Bigger games get around that limitation with a technique called memory banking. Memory banking essentially splits a larger ROM into banks, and lets you switch which bank is being accessed at a given time. This comes at the cost of extra circuitry, though. In original Game Boy cartridges, it's done using a specially made chip called a memory bank controller, or MBC. If you're making your own flash card to support ROMs bigger than 32K, you'll need to have MBC functionality. So you're either going to have to harvest an MBC chip from an original cartridge, or reproduce the logic somehow. There are a few ways to reproduce the logic. You could use simple logic chips, like this discontinued Inside Gadgets flash card. But that takes up a bunch of space and chips. You could get your own specialty chips manufactured, and if you have the money to spend on something like that, may I also point you to my Ko-fi? It's linked in the description. A more reasonable option is to use a programmable logic device, like a CPLD or an FPGA. I've used a PLD before for some cartridge shenanigans. They're fun. But that's not the approach Allison took. She's decided to use an RP2040 microcontroller. It's the chip that powers the Raspberry Pi Pico. It seems she didn't exactly choose the RP2040 for this project. She chose this project as a way to learn about the RP2040's programmable I/O, or PIO. That's great. If you've seen my videos about making a Game Boy emulator, you'll know that I love this approach to learning, where you find a project that gives you a reason to learn, and lets you see the applications of what you're learning while you're learning. So, it makes me happy to see someone accomplished and skilled like Allison also using this technique. Anyway, Allison wanted to learn some stuff, so she made this flash cart. Why should anyone else care? I mean, she didn't even make a YouTube video about it. Come on! Here are my top 4 reasons why anyone else should care. CPLDs and FPGAs are pretty specialized stuff. I mean, they're cool, and learning about them is fun, but they're not straightforward. I only used a PLD because I stumbled on them while browsing DigiKey for components. I didn't know what I was doing, and Ben Eater tricked me into thinking it'd be easy to figure out and program. In the end, I had to buy a specialized programmer, which I'm glad I did, and figure out how to use the most Windows 95-looking software I'd ever seen. I had to find a specific DLL and install it into my Wine environment to get it to run. And I didn't write anything down about it, so I have no idea if I could get it to work again. It was fun, though. Also, the idea of harvesting an MBC from an original cartridge is... I don't like it. If you want to do it, go for it. I don't have a problem. It's just not something I feel okay about doing myself. It's the same reason why I don't want to do any modding to original hardware that still works. Retro mods are cool. I love to see them. I love that other people are doing them. I've watched all of my cool Uncle Marissa's modding videos. I love it. It's just not something I'm comfortable doing myself. But an RP2040 is ubiquitous, and you program it over USB with a bunch of different languages. If you already know how to program, then a Raspberry Pi Pico is one of the easiest ways to get into doing hardware things. Plus, you can get them as cut tape. Look at this. This just feels like pure potential to me. Besides having an easy-to-get MBC replacement, Allison also points out that she designed this cartridge with modern 3.3-volt components. The Game Boy uses 5-volt stuff, but 5-volt components are getting harder and more expensive to get. It's not a huge problem yet, but new electronics tend to be designed to use 3.3-volt components. Of course, you'll need to convert between 5-volt and 3-volt signals, and that's where these come in. They're called level shifters, and they let the 3.3-volt world on the cartridge talk to the 5-volt world in the Game Boy. You can tell Allison is a hacker, because she designed this cartridge to be played with. I mean, it's a game cartridge, so of course it's meant to be played with. I mean the hardware is meant to be played with. She designed it as a prototype for a full-blown Game Boy cartridge development board. A big part of this is just having the RP2040. Since it's so easy to program, you can add new features. One thing Allison did with this is she wrote some code to make the ABC act like a multi-card, which is a cartridge that holds multiple games. It's pretty neat. You have multiple ROMs loaded on the cartridge with a special launcher ROM stored in the first 32K of the cartridge's ROM chip. When you boot the Game Boy, you'll get the launcher ROM, which lets you pick the ROM you want to play. After that, when you boot the Game Boy, the RP2040 will make it look to the Game Boy like the start address of your chosen ROM is actually ROM address 0. It does the same kind of thing for the SRAM, so that different ROMs don't overwrite each other's save data. So it's kind of like a super MBC. I really like how the RP2040 remembers which ROM to use between boots, so once you pick a ROM, it's like it's just a cartridge for that ROM. You don't have to care that it's actually a multi-cart. When you want to change ROMs, you boot the Game Boy while holding the button that's on the cartridge, and it'll bring you back to the launcher. I like it, and it's probably not how I would have tried to do it, which makes it double neat. The other thing is that Allison designed the ABC with two cuttable traces, so that if you only need ROMs that are 4 megabytes or less, or you don't care about NBC2 support, you can cut those traces and use them as extra RP2040 GPIOs for doing fun things. If you change your mind, you can undo the cut with an easy solder bridge. Also, look at this other cartridge she made. It's beautiful. You can tell Allison is a teacher, because it says so on her website. But also, while working on ABC, she created a document with everything she learned about Game Boy cartridges along the way. She's quick to point out that it's not new research. It's all based on info that's already out there. As she says, it's her attempt to gather together information relevant to making custom Game Boy cartridges in one place, and present that information in a way that's easy to digest for people who start off with about the same level of knowledge she started off with. So if you're interested in building your own cartridges, that document is a great place to start. If you want to get your hands on one of these carts, Allison is selling some unpopulated PCBs on her Ko-fi shop, linked in the description. You'll still need to get all the components and do the soldering. She also has the KiCad files available, so you can get a PCB made from a manufacturer. She recommends JLC PCB, due to price. While we're talking about RP2040 based carts, I also want to mention a totally different approach that others have taken, where you leave out the flash ROM and SRAM chips and just let the RP2040 interface directly with the Game Boy. That means that the RP2040 will be acting as though it's memory, sending the appropriate data whenever the Game Boy tries to read from ROM. It's wild that that even works, and you can buy them from Croco Electronics. There's also a similar cartridge that I found on Reddit. I have no idea if there's any relation between the two, or if it's just an example of multiple people having the same idea independently. Anyway, this is cool. You should make a Game Boy cartridge. Bye!